How's it going, everyone? It's me, Derpy. As we all know, the Uni King Eritaki Ito is right around the corner, and some of you might be debating if he's worth pulling or skipping. So in this video, I'll try to help you decide if you want to pull, if you're just on the edge of trying to decide if you want to pull for him or not. But before we jump into the video, there's a few disclaimers. There'll be no comparison to other characters or knowing if he is going to be a broken character or not. Currently, his understanding of him is very low, and we don't know what the best combo for him is yet. So until release, we won't really know how much damage he's capable of doing, but we can just throw on some artifacts just to do some calculation to see if his damage even compares to like anything that's reasonable. Now that's out of the way, we can take a look at Ito's kit, which is very unique and should be your primary reason for pulling. And second reason being the character design. Unlike all other Claymore characters, gameplay that basically involves clicking mouse one over and over again, and maybe throwing some elemental skills just to spice things up. Just TLDR, it's not very fun to play. Instead, we can do charge attacks. And if you have no idea what Ito's kit does, let me explain, as I also had no idea before researching for this video. Normal attack. Fight Club Legend. This is Ito's normal attack, but it's very unique. It has the normal stuff like the 4-hit normal attack combo that doesn't get interrupted by a dash or elemental skill. Let me repeat that again. Normal attack doesn't get interrupted by a dash or elemental skill. Ito has basically a C6 Diluc constellation built into his normal attack. Can we all just have a moment of silence for all the Diluc mains out there? But that's not what's very important here. The important part is his charge attack. I mean, it's still important, but his charge attacks are where most of our damage is going to be coming from. So unlike other Claymore characters, charge attack that basically involve them becoming a Beyblade or doing whatever this is, Ito's charge attack has three different attacks depending on the amount of superlative super strength he has. Before I explain other skills, let me explain what superlative super strength does. And I'll call this SS from now on, just because it's easier to say. So SS stacks up to 5 times and goes away after 60 seconds, and there are many ways for us to gain SS stacks like normal attacks, elemental skill, and elemental burst states. But we'll talk about all that later depending on how many SS stacks Ito has. It will depend on what type of charge attack he performs. So let's quickly run down the 3 types of charge attacks. Eritaki Kisagiri's combo slash. Ito performs this when consuming SS stacks. Unless it's the last stack and this doesn't consume stamina. Eritaki Kisagiri Final Slash. This special attack is when Ito only has one SS stack left or the last one, and this was much stronger compared to the combo slash. Sachimunji Slash. A single slash when there is no SS stacks. Very slightly weaker compared to the combo slash. So this is how SS stack works and how charge attack depends on them. But how do we get SS stacks? Like I said before, there are many ways to get SS stacks. The first is from the second and fourth strike of the normal attack hitting an opponent. This will gain us 1 or 2 stacks. But there are also ways to get them from elemental skill and elemental burst, but we'll talk about that in those sections of the video. Ito's elemental skill summons Ushi, a bow that deals geo damage. Ushi will have 100% scaling off Ito's max HP, taunting enemies, and will flee when the HP reaches 0 or duration ends. Holding down the skill will unit decide where you want to throw Ushi, and like any other geo construct, it will act like a geo construct. There are many ways Ushi will give us SS stacks, and here's all of them. When dealing damage, we'll gain 1 stack. When Ushi is hit, will also gain a stack, but this can only happen once every 2 seconds. When Ushi flees or duration ends, you also gain another stack. So there are 3 ways you can get stacks, but there's more ways to get stacks with elemental burst. Ito's elemental burst, Royal Descent, Behold Ito the Evil. Ito lets out his inner raging Uni King, converting Ito's normal attack damage to geo damage, and this cannot be overwritten. Also increase normal attack speed based on Ito's defense, and increase Ito's elemental and physical resistance by 20%. As for SS stacks, in Raging Uni King state, Ito's first and third normal attack also gains us 1 stack of SS. To recap all the ways you can get SS stacks, hitting opponent with your second normal attack will gain us 1 stack, hitting opponent with your 4th normal attack will gain us 2 stacks, hitting opponent with elemental skill, 1 stack, Wuxi getting attacked 1 stack every 2 seconds, Wuxi fleeing, 1 stack, in Raging Uni King state, hitting opponent with 1st or 3rd normal attack both give us 1 stack. Now that's everything about skills, but let's talk about passive talents and constellations now. First passive talent, Woodchuck Chucked, turns Ito's party into a professional group of lumberjacks. When Ito is in the party, there is 25% chance of getting additional logs from hitting trees. This is very useful and you should pull Ito just based on this talent. Passive talent 2, Eritaki Ichiban. When using Eritaki Kisugiri, that's his charge attack with SS stacks, each slash will increase attack speed of the next slash by 10%, maximum of 30%. This also increases his resistance to interruptions, and his effect will be cleared after he stops these consecutive slashes. His last passive talent, Bloodline of the Crimson Uni. Ito's attack is increased by 35% of Ito's defense. This one's pretty self-explanatory, just build a bunch of defense on Ito. Lastly, constellations. I can't tell you if the constellations are worth it because it's all going to be dependent on what you think it's worth it or not. To me, C1 might seem like a very good constellation, a must get for anybody that wants to pull over Ito. To you, it might not be important at all. And also, I don't think C1's like you have to pull for C1. That's just an example. It's your hard-earned primal gems. You choose what you spend them on. I'll throw up just a picture of each constellation, what they do on the screen. Pause if you want to read them and you don't know what they do, as I won't be explaining them. C1 seems to be a nice DPS increase, might be nice to have. C2 removes some of the energy recharge requirement and allows you to build into more damage stats. C3, it's a nice increase in DPS, but probably not important at all. C4, nice to have for long rotations. Ito can gain the 20% defense buff himself, maybe, and making the whole team just a little bit better. C5 is just a nice little upgrade. C6, probably broken. Who knows? Maybe. I don't know. Alright, time for some number calculations and assumptions. Like I said before, don't base your polling off of these numbers. These are just to see if his attacks can even do damage at all. We don't know his best combo yet, and we won't find out until his release to know what much damage he can do. So please don't poll based off of these numbers. These are only for us to see if his attacks can even do damage at all, and spoiler alert, it does some damage. So here are the list of assumptions we're going to be making in our calculations. Level 90 Ito at C0, level 9 talents on everything. We'll be looking at 3 different weapons: Red Horn for the whales for lucky people, R1, Serpent Spine for the light spenders, we're going to put this at R5, and White Bind for the F2P players out there, and this will be also R5. All weapons will have max possible stacks. Artifact piece will be the 4-piece husk with 4 stacks. Main stats on artifact would be defense percentage on the sand, geo percent on the goblet with crit on the crown. Substats will be the Kachin main, standard, 20 liquid and 20 fixed for high investment builds. Energy recharge 130% before anything else. We'll have geo resonance, will be the Uni King state, which is his elemental burst. An enemy will be a level 90 Hiller Troll. There is a great calculator out there for Ito, and there'll be one I'll be using in this video, linked in the description if you want to plug in some of your own artifact stat to see how much damage you can do. And here are the numbers. So we can basically ignore the plunge damage as we probably won't be plunging a lot, and just take a look at the normal and charge attacks. So damage is very acceptable for a Claymore character, but then again, we can't draw any conclusions on if he'll be the next busted DPS character, and he probably won't be, but who knows. I do believe that his kit will be very, very hard to play, and we need to manage SS stacks very well, and might need to change combos on the fly depending on certain circumstances. Like for example, if Wuxi gets attacked too much and takes too much damage and flees too soon, you might need to change your combo that way. If he stays the whole duration, or if he doesn't get attacked fast enough, you might need to change your combo that way. So there's a lot of factors involved that can easily change the way you play Ito. And if you're someone that likes to play characters like Freeze Ganyu, Xiao, Yula, or even like Diluc, for example, which doesn't require much for a lack of a better word, skill to play, then I don't think Ito will be a fun character to play for you, as the combos can be quite different depending on the situation. Another type of players Ito is not good for is for the DPS players. Not the damage per second players, but the damage per screenshot players. Nothing in his kit does huge burst DPS, so sorry for you guys, you need to wait a little longer for a DPS character to be released. But let's say you don't have the skills to play Ito, where you are a damage per screenshot player, but you just like the way Ito looks, then all rights to you, go for it, pull him, I won't argue with you. So hope you guys find this video helpful when you're trying to decide if you want to pull for Ito or not, and hope this video helped you come to a conclusion of if you're pulling or skipping. So best of luck for anyone that's pulling for Ito, and thank you guys for watching, and have a great day.